potatoes, it's Corey. So today I'm gonna show you everything I bought from Miss A. Miss A is a store in Houston. I honestly saw it on TikTok, like everything in my life, and everything there is like $1 to $1.88. That kind of varies depending on the brand, if it's Pawpaw or AOA. But I was like, man, I can't go. And I was like, think smarter, not harder. I got online. They have an online website, $35 free shipping. So you know I found a way to spend $35 at a dollar essential store online. Okay, so it's full. Technically, like by itemized, there was 34 items, but some items had 2 things in them, some items have 12 things in them. So I got a lot of things for $35. I hit that free shipping. Oh, the paying shipping, that's more items. Anybody that like is willing to pay shipping instead of buying more items, like if you're willing to pay shipping and handling rather than having a physical item you can hold in your hand, you're willing just to pay for the air that's getting things here. Nope, we cannot be friends. It's not happening. So these are all the things I did with my dollar items, and honestly, it was the best thing. It was like, I've made a lot of online purchases, like way too many to count, okay? Too many. But Miss A, probably one of the better ones. So sit back, enjoy my virtual spending, and I give you a little makeup look, because the things I use out of the box, I show you how I use them. So enjoy. Stay till the end for the giveaway, or just hit the link in the bottom description box. Links are down there. It's still going on, okay? It's still here. It'll be here till I'm 80. So I'm using the rice powder. I show you how greasy my hair is. I first brush it out, and it comes with this little teeny tiny brush that I do attempt, but I'm not gonna lie, that was like a complete fail. It would have took me 100 years. So I got smarter and I thought of grabbing a big brush, and I used that, and that worked a lot better.
That obviously soaked up my oil. It obviously took way more time, but the biggest difference between like a typical dry shampoo, there's like no residue. Like my hair like literally feels like brand new, washed, fresh out of the shower. That's interesting. Rice powder.
This allows your phone to be suction cupped, and it also bends. This is me suction cupping you to the bathroom mirror, but be careful, it falls. Then I put my hair in a new scrunchie, open up this willow bark blemish soap, smells really good, lather it up, wash my face, and fall. My iPhone should be breaking. Take my hair out, try a new dry shampoo. Oh yeah, this is the size comparison.
These earrings are from Miss A. They're really, like, they look heavy, but these are super lightweight. Like, it literally feels like there's nothing in my ear. But the only thing was the back is just a little plastic. There's no, like, actual clasp. Things that I've, like, already used. I showed y'all scrunchies. I have one black scrunchie currently making up my little bun right there. My main one all the time to create my buns. So it was a pack of 3 black scrunchies for $1. And like I said, one is up here. I used dry shampoo. This little can I showed you compared to, like, a full-size bottle. I think I'm gonna throw this, like, in my purse. This would be good to have. As you saw when I was in the bathroom, this is what I used to hold you up on the bathroom mirror, suction cup, and my phone up to be, like, head on without all the, like, excess of a tripod. Sometimes this, like, holds for so long, other times it just, like, literally falls, and I think my phone's gonna be broken, all because of a $1 contraption. But it's actually pretty cool, and my hopes with this is to use it, like, when we are traveling, like in our car when I do my little check-in vlogs. I washed my face with this soap. It says it's blemish refining with willow bark deep cleansing, gently removes dirt, excess oils without drying out skin. Like, I don't feel dry, but I definitely feel like I washed my face with a bar of soap, which I haven't done that in years. Definitely feels like all the nutrients were taken out of my face. I'll say that. Y'all didn't see me use these, but this was 150 bobby pins for $1. I lose bobby pins all the time, so this was amazing. But this is rice powder, and I got so many different dry shampoos, oily hair or not. And so I was using this on a little brush and putting it where there's oil. It didn't leave like any residue. It just took like a lot longer. And I actually want to use this and try for setting makeup, or like when you get oily. I used this yesterday when I cleaned up my face and my eyebrows. I told you I was not liking this little guy, so I got this guy. This guy came in a 2-pack for $1 brow set. This one is smaller and comes with 2-sided comb, and then there's a giant one. Okay, this is phenomenal. I use my LightRay card. So this holds up your phone, and this has been great for all these virtual meetings when I'm having to do other things. And it does different heights based off the back, and then it just collapses flat. Like, literally just throw that in your bag, throw it anywhere. But I have seen much larger rectangle sizes of these at Dollar Tree. So if you're interested in something like this, they also have them at Dollar Tree. I got 2 rings that I love. Those both were $1. They didn't let you pick their size, but they worked out to be my size, so that was amazing. And I literally love those rings. So the rest of it, I'm just gonna, as I go, if I use it, I'll jump on here and show you. So you're just gonna start seeing my face randomly progress more beautiful than now. And then things I don't use, I'll go over in the end. So the first thing I'm gonna put on is
this Global Beauty Care Collagen Skin Cream. Really don't know if it's meant for daytime, nighttime, under makeup, but today it's gonna be made for daytime under makeup because feeling a little dry. I have the retinol one. They actually sell these at Dollar Tree. And if you follow my page, you know that I have been all about Dollar Tree skincare. There's like no scent. Real question though, when you're putting on skincare, like I have oils and creams, which one goes first? Somebody tell me. Carolyn thinks it's cream and then oil because she thinks oil just sits on your skin. I think it's oil and then cream because cream's heavier. So if you know the answer, which one goes first, please tell me. Okay, help me out. Collagen on. Plump this skin up. Okay, this Beauty Trends Coconut Lip Mask, hydrating lip balm for soft, smooth skin. I also think this is at Dollar Tree. So everything I couldn't find at Dollar Tree, aka things I saw on TikTok, I was able to find at Miss A. Looks like just like a balm. Woo! Caught it. Ooh, a lot came out. That was a mistake. She is a thick one. A little tingly.
A little tingly.
Okay, this is an Urban Studio Buffing Brush. Okay, does it look familiar? I wanted to see if it was comparable to the Morphe M6 for a dollar. Already, it doesn't feel like it. This is way more dense. More loose. I feel like I'm gonna lose a lot of product in there. We're gonna try it for foundation. Buffing 205 even has a number. I use a little bit light, so I have a little bit dark. I mean, it's moving it, but also feel like it's sucking it up. You see that little line? That's a bristle coming out. Completely just pulled all the foundation off that cheekbone right there. This never happens, but there's like no foundation left on my face to cover my nose. So I want to go back and add more foundation. Yikes. Okay, so for when I went back in to add, I put it on my hand right there and I touched that and then like just solely did patting motions all over it. Got way more coverage, still little bristle fallouts around my face. Would I buy more from this? No, but there's like a lot of little kids that are into makeup and I know people are like super against buying them those like cheap little sets that are made with like God knows what. I mean, I don't know what this made of, let's be honest, it's a dollar. But if I had like a young kid that was like into makeup and you're not trying to spend money on it, I would buy this dollar brush for them. Like this would work well for them just like playing around. Okay, so I have a little bit of cream contour on my face. I've already used this. It's very dirty from doing this from like a TikTok from just being messy. But I actually want to do it right this time. So I'm just going to spray this beauty blender from them. I don't know if it's the same one, but I bought two different ones. I know it's not the same. Like, I don't know if it's the same brand is what I mean. Like, this one's by Pawpaw. I don't know if this one's by somebody else. I threw away the packaging. AOA Wonder Blender Pink Teardrop. And people said it was a dupe for the original beauty blender, and I wouldn't know because I don't own an original beauty blender. And now we're about to blend. For my joke of a TikTok, it worked really well. It worked out this whole quarantine. Gotta get rid of the jeans real quick. I was gonna take everybody's word for it. It works really well for me. So since this one is so dirty from using so much bronzer, I'm gonna take the clean one, a lot brighter pink, the Pawpaw Wonder Blender, and I'm gonna use this one to put on my concealer. Ooh, she is soft. Wow. It's like a marshmallow. This one feels softer than the other one. The one's probably internally screaming. I put on my bronzer and then my concealer because it's like covering it up, but whatever. I don't use a cream contour, okay? I just wanted to try my beauty blenders. A what? I need like 100 of these. Wow, I'm shooketh. I thought I had another favorite item, but like, whoa. I just wanna walk around with a cream face, nothing else. Like this looks, what? I can't get over this. Wow, I need to set this. I usually don't set with white powder. I usually set with my Morphe Banana setting. It's way more yellow, but I got this in my BoxyCharm, so might as well try it out. We were going through some things. This eyebrow was good staying home. This eyebrow is ready to break free. They're far distant cousins today. This look looks crazy. I know this is like the worst little transition spot ever to be in, but next thing I'm gonna use is this Shadow Armor little fallout. They go under your eyes to catch your fallout. I don't wanna like purposely use a palette that has a bunch of fallout. I'm just gonna use my palettes. The one thing I'm gonna try to do different is not tap my palettes that I do out of habit. So any fallout that happens, it just happens. And after I got these, I was like almost positive that I could get way more somewhere else. I don't know, I feel like you get way more off some other website, but I was pushing to hit $35. So there is like a sticky backing. Okay, we're just gonna figure figure it out. Here's a stupid question. Why do I need to stick the bottom half? I'm positive my lashes are stuck under there, so pray for me. Can I be cheap and just do one eye at a time? I just reached back and grabbed a random palette. My Easter basket is still over there. Cute photo of all the stuff I got from Morphe and ColourPop from Caroline. So I just grabbed the 15D Day Slayer. So I need some brushes. I ain't done my makeup in years. Is this eyeshadow? I'm gonna use a M518. I'm gonna grab the shade. Jesus, this is huge for your hand. I feel like I've never used my 15s. Grab neutral. Don't tap anything. I mean, technically I can get close to that edge. I'm not hitting skin. Just feel like my eyes being like pulled open. Is this what severe allergies feel like? On a M321, I'm gonna grab up B. It's like an orange tan. I'm gonna go right in the crease. Same brush, go over to this side. Switch over to the 518, nothing on it, and just diffuse that out. Grabbing an R39, little rose gold flathead, and I'm gonna grab the shade Epic. That is rich. That is like a really rich brown. I like that. It is catching it for sure. I have a Morphe 9A sitting here. I'm gonna get in so much trouble. I think I also got this for Easter. I'm gonna grab the shade Surprise to do my creases because there's not a light enough shimmer shade in here to lighten this up. Remember this old trick? I was like, I made this up. I don't know if I really did. I did cut my crease, but taking that upbeat, there's like a tiny bit amount, little tip, just outline, more definition. But for now, I'm gonna let it be and I'm gonna do the other side. I'm gonna flip this over there. So when I did that, that for sure took my makeup off. What is the point of that if it takes my makeup off? No. No. Okay, I did flip it. It is sticking and I did blend it back out, but that is stupid. Okay, on this side, I really didn't pull anything off. So I'm so confused. Still gonna do a little pat pat just for safekeeping. There's like a clear, like, I took off your makeup over here. But this is a liquid eyeliner. About to ruin this look right now. The trickery is real. Oh my god, this looks like an absolute mess. You know what? I'm doing my face so I can like actually look cute. And then if I ruin it with this, we'll come back to it. I've literally done everything I possibly could do to avoid putting this on to this moment. Considered looking at how to do my taxes for next year. Because I'm really avoiding doing this. Okay, it looks like there's a little angle on it. I'm just not gonna talk. I think it can sense my fear. It does mattify down like really nicely and really quick. I need to do it. I need to just do it. I need to do it. Oh my gosh. This is what people feel like when they go like skydiving. This is what I feel like when I put a winged eyeliner on with a new eyeliner. Mistakes are being made. As predicted, I started to lose control when I started to do the actual wings. So I'm gonna grab something else. Okay, for how stressful that was, we came through. And then you throw in this dollar flawless. Flawless, definition of flawless. It ain't these wings, but they on. I don't know if it's the matte finish, but it is like tightening. When I close, especially when I went like outside, I made the wing. It is tightening, so that mattifying, like that drying down, it is pulling the skin a little bit. Okay, lashes. I have been considering, just because I'm sitting at home doing nothing, putting back on my lash extensions, and this time not ripping them out when I'm ready to take them out, but I haven't done it yet. But just in case, I bought some flare long black single lashes to put on. I'm gonna put on Chloe. And then I also bought this lash applicator because it was in like everyone's review. And let's just take a look into how that wing came about. I'm about to go sit on my porch and pass something out so someone can see me. That was real time, no edits. Was that real? I'm about to go to Sonic or something. Chloe, did you know, girl? Three glosses and one matte. So I'm gonna put the matte down and I'm gonna pick a gloss. Probably one of these two, cause it's like pink. These are by AO Studio. I will say the tube is a little beat up. Ooh, she's light. Not a look, sis, not a look. Okay, so on video, I don't feel like the lips look as bad as they look in person. But that gloss was nice. I'm not swatching the other two. They're glosses. Starting out, these two. This is the same line and collection. I bet it's just as blinding, popping as this one. So I feel like it would be really good. This one is a different one. It says it's holographic, so I would hope it'd be even more like bam in your face.
What's left in my box?
This is a gel gold face mask. I was looking at this for Dollar Tree and I could not find it anywhere, and then they had it, so I picked it up. White nail polish. I was completely out of white nail polish. No, I wasn't. My nail polish was super old. This, I should use this now and redo these lips, but we've been on here long enough. I know probably no one's watching. These lip makeup remover mask. I was thinking more for my like Stila and Anastasia. Like, these would be good to get them off. These little compact powder puffs. They kept advertising these pads in hashtag normalize periods, so I bought these, even though literally three for a dollar. You can get way more in a like a bigger pack. These I thought were headbands and they fooled me, because only head these are fitting are baby dolls. They're actually little ponies. I put one in my ponytail like that. Hair conditioning mask. It's literally a mask, like this whole thing is a mask. You wrap your hair up, condition your hair. And then this last one, spray tanning, exfoliating. It's a bath towel. Whoa, this is a green screen. This is a joke. This is a cut piece of fabric, scissor lines there. I got played on this one. Wow, this is a piece of Joann's fabric. Okay, so that is everything from Miss A online. Didn't go in person, so chill it out. I am pleasantly surprised. I only feel like I got failed like with those eye patches. The eyeliner when I tried to do a wing, which is probably my fault. That is my fault. The lip color, I picked up too light of a shade, so my fault. I mean, y'all just saw it, so if I look played, I got played. That was like Dollar Tree, but like trendy Dollar Tree, but shipping time of Wish. So thank you so much for watching. When this world opens up, Carolyn don't know, but we about to take a trip to Houston, because in the store there's way more stuff. I've seen videos. So anyways, giveaway still going on. To hit 500 subscribers, you have to like my Instagram, like my YouTube, like my Facebook, and comment the word petty on any video. All links are in the description box below. One winner, not internationally, not sponsored by anybody, will be the winner of a $25 Ulta gift card, a Too Faced tote bag, a small acrylic jar, and a Scandalous Glow highlight. And that is the giveaway when we hit 500 one day. I just do this for me. Bye, potatoes.